Yo, what's up?
How are you doing?
Bro, Vova.
So what did you bring for us today?
Periodontic teeth with, gingival recession, bone resorption, a lot of calculus and plaque and everything.
It happened over time?
Yeah, it happens over time when your hygiene is awful. You can see that he only has three teeth, probably one of them just fell.
So the two teeth move away one from another when your hygiene is bad?
You can see he has only three teeth in the middle.
Yes.
One is missing. One has probably fell down because of the same problems. Probably this one. And then they just moved one from another.
To compensate for
the compensate for the space, yeah.
Biology is awesome.
The lower teeth need to be extracted. There is not much that you can do because over time, you lose them anyway. So in the meanwhile, as we can extract and place implants and make something temporary on his teeth, it's much better because you control the process. You control the process of the restoration. You can always have something temporary for the aesthetical purposes and functional, and not the other way, when you just need to extract everything and you think about what we're going to do.
This is the temporary lower bridge.
This is the lower temporary. We partially extracted some of the teeth and placed implants. And on the other teeth, we prepared them and cemented the bridge on the teeth. On the upper jaw, you can see that...
Wait, you said in the previous video that it's not good to connect.
You're not connecting. We're placing implants, we're closing them, but the bridge itself is only on teeth.
And it's okay, it won't destroy the teeth, it won't hurt them.
It's teeth that eventually you'll
extract?
You'll extract anyway.
Oh, I see.
But this way you can have something temporary in the process. On the upper jaw, he has a couple of implants on the lower side, on the right side, and in the middle, one implant. So we already had the implants we needed to make a restoration. So on his right side, you can see cement restoration of three implants. You can see that there is still some cement residues and a little bit of inflammation around the abutments. We removed the crown also from the anterior implant.
Also cement restoration?
No, I think it was a screw retained, it was PFM crown. And we placed multi-units on the posterior and the anterior implant.
Straight multi-units?
Yeah, straight multi-units for this case. Then placed can abutments. We took impressions, we made a bridge that connects all of those implants, and we virtually extracted the other teeth. So eventually you can extract the teeth and right away place the bridge.
Oh, so you made the bridge prior to the extraction?
Exactly.
Saves time?
Yeah. Not saves time, but he still has his teeth in the process of the preparation of the bridge.
This is the loaded bridge in the mouth.
Yeah, this is the bridge on the implants. So you can see that we extracted, you can see a little bit of blood and swelling. We extracted the teeth and mounted right away the bridge on those implants.
And you took it out of occlusion?
No, why? They're already osteointegrated. No. It's the lower bridge on the teeth, the upper jaw, the upper bridge is on the implants that were previously placed. And we also placed a couple of implants because we didn't want to have only three on one side, two on the back side, and only one in the middle. And we want to have a little bit of more in the middle. So what we did is we placed a couple of implants in the canine area and made another bridge when right away. We made another bridge on those two implants. It was immediate loading, but because you already had a posterior and anterior implant, it almost won't affect at all the newly implanted implants.
And why not to use angulated multi-units?
Because you don't need to use here. Angulated multi-units you'll see in the buccal part, because the angulated multi-unit have a small buccal bulge. In this case, you don't need to use it. It will be flawed in aesthetical aspects. So it's much better to have a straight multi-units almost always when you can use them.
This is zirconia.
Yeah.
This is the zirconia bridge, the upper bridge. We'll start cementing the sleeves one by one. On the lower bridge, we'll cement at first the anterior ones, then screw all of them into the mouth, and then we'll cement the posterior ones, and then screw all everything in the mouth. This way, we can compensate about different distortions that you have in the process of
preparation.
Like the small division.
Yeah, you can have that.
You can see that we, eventually we had a small gap on one of the sleeves, but you can close this gap with the composite material and it's fine. You will have a passive fit for this bridge.
So when you do this protocol, you want to have a passive fit, and then you know that everything you've done is perfect.
Yeah.
This is both the zirconia bridges.
Yeah, this is the upper and lower zirconia bridge.
This looks really big.
The lower teeth are really big because we did want to keep the same vertical dimension of occlusion. And in the same time, he did have some bone resorption and gingival recessions. So on the lower jaw, you will have a very big teeth. The upper jaw is not the same because the upper teeth were not that big.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
And thank you for being with us today. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe and follow to stay tuned with the latest cases. Thank you and have a great week.